This is a really exciting moment to be in right now, just in the industry and Red Hat in particular for it. And this revolves around AI and specifically generative AI. All of us probably know generative AI, maybe not the term, from the 2022 launch of ChatGPT. Now, there are some predictions we can make in technology at this point around this capability. The first is that it's here to stay. It's impacted every walk of life, every company at this point. Two, we know that there will be choice. There's not going to be one solution. Just the explosion of choices in the last year has been incredible. And three, we know this is going to revolve around open source. We're really excited about the open source potential because it widens who can contribute to this, from academia to people contributing new skills and knowledge. Joe, why don't you tell them a little bit more about what we're doing?
Great. So Red Hat and IBM are partnering on an open approach to AI model development. Now, we know that training models is expensive. The pre-training process is hugely compute intensive. Only a few companies in the world can do this. We also know that once you have a model, it's hard to teach that model something new. So IBM developed the lab methodology for model alignment. Lab creates a taxonomy-driven approach to adding skills and knowledge to a model. It tries to teach a model in the same way that we learn. And it makes model development more accessible to end users. Now, Red Hat and IBM have also launched the InstructLab open source community to drive this. This actually includes the InstructLab tools, the solution that implements the lab methodology, as well as newly open sourced Granite models from IBM, all packaged together in a new community-driven approach to model development. From this community, we'll drive new enterprise products from Red Hat.
So these new enterprise product capabilities are going to show up in a product we're excited about that we will call RHEL AI. The reason we're doing this is we've talked to customers. The vast majority of them are in what we would consider development today. They're working with models, they're excited about the potential for them, but they haven't yet moved them into production. So our focus is making sure we can introduce a product that helps them get into that phase.
Yeah, so RHEL AI is a foundation model platform. It helps customers seamlessly develop, test, and deploy Granite-based large language models in the enterprise. Now, RHEL AI includes the Open Granite model family, the InstructLab model alignment tools, all packaged together in an enterprise distribution of RHEL that's optimized and bootable immediately to seamlessly deploy across any environment, whether that's based on NVIDIA, AMD, or Intel hardware. And then that all comes with enterprise support, lifecycle, and indemnification of the models from Red Hat.
This is something you might see the familiarity with of what Red Hat was able to do in making Linux innovation accessible to the enterprise. We're really excited with this foundation platform to see if we can do the same thing around AI. This lowers the barrier for everyone in a company to be able to contribute these skills and knowledge that they have.
And since RHEL AI is based on the InstructLab community project, it really gives everybody the ability to contribute something larger. So when you have skills and knowledge that you want to contribute to the open community, you can do that through the InstructLab project and see those skills and knowledge reflected in weekly builds that we'll be doing of our new model family. That will then in turn drive what comes into our enterprise products that you can then further tune with your own skills and knowledge data, just as Matt described. So we're super excited about RHEL AI. We're super excited about the InstructLab community, and we can't wait to see you get started.
This is also building AI the open source way, allowing people around the world to drive the innovation for the future of AI.